that you hold on to, that you grasp so dearly, gets tried over and over again in the place of a YO camp. And it's hard, it was hard. But now, through the trials and tribulations, the Lord has strengthened me tremendously. I come from a broken home, and to see what the Lord has done for me seeking His face, bringing my family back together because of the love that He has for me and the love that shines through me, it's tremendous because He shines a light on my family that I never could have done without Him. And it blesses my heart to be able to see that Jesus can bring my family together, because if you were to see my family on the outside looking in, there would be no hope. But with Jesus, there is hope. And I hold on to that because the cycle of destruction that we go through, that we live in, that we're born in, keeps going and going until something gets your attention. And for me, that was Jesus Christ. To be able to heal that and start with me, to be able to break that cycle of destruction, was, can't even put it into words, because I get to be the block, the first block that builds the bridge to connecting a full circle of not destruction, but of hope and love and faith, and multiply and love for my family. And that's big to me, and that's what I hold on to because of the love that He's shown me and that He still shows me. If I could explain or tell you guys anything, is to seek Jesus' face for the love that He has for you, that Jesus died on the cross for you, and the things that He did so you could be whole. Just ask Him to please come into your life and fill that void, that when you lay down at night and something isn't right, you don't know what's wrong, how to fix it, ask Him to fix it, and He will, because He did it to me. Thank you very much. I'm Christian Bonham.
My name is McGrady Sam. My life has been like a rolling stone before I came to prison. And I had never underestimated me coming to prison. But I just got caught up in the fast lane. I know through the grace of God, for me to be sent to a place where I can kind of get myself together and get my head on straight. And from the time I came in, you know, it's been a rough journey, but as it comes to an end, it gets smoother and smoother, because it's the power through God that's brought me this far. You know, by me being here, I've learned a lot from each camp. I've met a lot of Christian brothers that I would like to see once I heal this. And, my journey has been very good, because most of the time I was in prison, I always went to work camps, which enabled me to be on work squads. And in the work squad that I was on, I was always fortunate enough to be a, like a little straw boss, because the officers always put a lot of trust in me to like run the squads. And one day when I got in, my homeboys told me, said, "Man, you're finna be transferred." I said, "No, that can't be happening to me, because I was comfortable where I was, and I wanted to do all my time there." And so I said, "Lord, I've always put my faith and trust in you, because I've always said, it's not where I want to be, it's where I want you to place me at." So they told me, "Said, for you to be transferred." I said, "No, I don't believe that." So a guy came to me and said, "Man, you're going to be transferred." I didn't know where I was going, because I didn't sign up to be transferred to no place. And so when they told me it was going to be like a hotel, I said, "Well, it can't be too bad." So that morning they told me we had to be transferred. So I came, when we came to Atlanta, we sat for like 2 weeks. And so everybody was saying the transition. I said, I've never heard of transition house. So when I got here, I said, Lord, it got to be a gift through God to place me here. So by me being here, you know, it's what you put into it, what you get out of it. By me being here like 21 months, I have really, really got a lot out of the program. It's things that I never thought that I would do, as far as going back to class, trying to get a GED, learning the computer, different things like that. And the church service has been great because God will, you know, put people in your life that will help you along your journey. And by me being here, you know, I've got a lot of brothers that have EOS, that have gone home, that are always, you know, remember these guys, they were like family. And it's a lot of brothers that's here right now, including the pastors, are like family members. So I just thank the Lord for allowing me to come here. It's a gift through God to be chosen to come here. And I just want to be able to say, prison is what you put into it. If you come here and just take it to be something to play with, you won't get nothing out of it. But me as an individual, you got to help me along the ways to learn things that I never thought I would be, that I would never think that I would be able to learn by going to different countries and just, you know, meet people that I have learned from and people that have been encouraged to me. You know, I have 4 months left, and a lot of the stuff that I've learned here now, I'm going to try to take and apply to my life and let God play me where he wants me to be at. Thanks a lot.
Hi, my name is John Gill. I'm from Selma, North Carolina, and I'm currently down in St. Cloud, Florida, at the Transition House. Now, you may ask yourself a question, how did I get here? Well, I know it was the will of God. For every day, I trust in the Lord. I lean not to my own understanding. In all my ways, I acknowledge him, and he do direct my path. Sometimes he direct my path through hills, valleys, hedges, byways. I mean, all walks of life, the Lord has blessed me to walk through and study, because the Bible declares us to study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. As you grow, and as I grow, and my spiritual walk with my Father, I know he's my Father. I know he received me with the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. And that's Father, Father. When you study the words of Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, you'll find out he's letting you know that you are a son of God as well. I pray that this message get through to you. You are a son of the Most High God. Whether you are obedient or disobedient, you still belong to God. For the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof and all they that dwell therein. So I thank God for being allowed to give this testimony tonight, because I've gone through a lot in my life, but the main thing I've gone through is a beautiful walk with my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. See, I'm one of those choir boys. I was raised up in church all my life. I didn't have a choice on whether or not I was going to church. I didn't even have a choice on whether or not I was going to preach. My grandmother called me her little preacher from the age of 5. I've been standing up in front of crowds since I can remember, singing and praising God. And my grandmother, she told me something as a kid that sticks with me to this day. She said, when you sing, sing unto the Lord. Do not sing unto people. Because sometimes you'll get caught up and you'll want their praise rather than getting the perfect praise which comes from above, which is from our Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I thank God for the upbringing that I had. It wasn't the greatest upbringing in the world, but I cannot use that as an excuse for where I'm at right now. I cannot blame nobody in my family for the things that I went through. Even though they knew better, I still can't blame them, because I forgave them of those things. And I've noticed, as I've gotten closer to my Father, he has removed the resentment, the bitterness, the hatred. Now today, I sit down in front of people and I minister every day just because I know I am a son of God. I hope and pray that you're getting this, because by you listening to this, you are letting the devil know that you are a child of the Most High King. You know, and the Bible declares whom the Son set free is free indeed. Once we receive the spirit of adoption, once we receive the word of God as being a love letter from our Father to us, then he will give us the power that we need to overcome the world. So I pray that not only do you understand this message, but I also pray that this message just grabs you and just covers you in the love of God. For if you study the scriptures, you'll see in Psalms chapter 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So the more you study, the more you are in his presence. We want Shekinah glory. We want that glory that the world know nothing about. And that's what I'm focused on right now. I could tell you my testimony, the ups and the downs, the drugs, the money. I just can't tell you everything. I don't have enough time to tell you everything that's happened to me in my life. But I do have enough time to tell you about my Father. He's glorious. He's wonderful. He's a counselor. He's your judge. He's your advocate. He's your healer. He's everything you need. Study his word, and he will give it to you. He will let you see it for yourself. And he will invite you into the kingdom of heaven just like he's invited me. Because nobody can change my mind and nobody can convince me of sin. I know the Bible declares, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. So I pray that you understand that and start thinking of yourself as a child of the Most High God with the power. Jesus Christ came back and told his disciples after he was raised. He said, all power has been given unto me in heaven and in earth. So for those of us who have received Christ Jesus, and those of us who have been baptized with the fire of the Holy Spirit, and those of us who have had that burning bush experience, we know who we are, and you know who you are. Take a moment now. Selah. Meditate. Thank God you're still breathing. Thank God that you had another day. And thank God for this message. May the Lord bless you, and I bid you Godspeed.
Yes, my name is Joseph Lima. I'm currently in a work release prison in Florida. I started in the drugs when I was probably about 15 years old. And it was pretty much due to my family life. I was tossed around pretty much from the time I was 2 all the way up until 16. My family was in and out. They got divorced at a young age. I got in a lot of trouble because I started hanging out with the wrong crowd. I had a bigger brother that was in gangs, and I followed that lifestyle in Chicago. I got into a lot of trouble. Learned how to sell drugs and do drugs. And, you know, as my life was going, I learned one thing, that it wasn't the right place for me. I was always getting in trouble, and I just couldn't go through my life without doing drugs just to get by. You know, right now I'm currently in here for trafficking pills. I chose to do that. It was a bad choice, and I know it was wrong. Before I got put in, I found Jesus back in 2006, shortly after I got out of county jail for selling cocaine to undercover. You know, it took me a while to realize that I needed Jesus in my life. And I chose to start going to church and trying to follow the right path. I was working for Youth for Christ and helping out teenagers and also youth at my church. You know, as I was going through, I was still slipping. We all slip. We all fall short of the glory of God. And, you know, I learned that, but I ended up falling anyway. You know, and this time around, I got 3 years. You know, and it hit me hard because I had to go away from my family and my 2 daughters. And, you know, it was just something that we have to learn as we go. Those pains that we go through and the struggles we go through, we learn as we go through, and it makes us stronger as long as you take it and use it. And Jesus has showed me that. You know, he showed me a lot of love through my life, protecting my kids, protecting me. You know, he saved my daughter. He saved my life one time when I OD'd at 17. And, you know, it's just a long process, you know, and prison isn't the right place to be. We got to choose to make the right decisions so we don't have to end up here. And You know, I learned a lot as I was gone, and I thank God for that.